right where I didn't put sunscreen.
All right, my red.
Got it.
Okay. You ready? One, two, three.
pomp and circumstance. Ready?
Graduates, if you could please slow down just a minute. I know you're excited, but let's get our welcome in. Good evening. My name is Andrea Derrickson, and I'm the assistant principal of Charleston School of the Arts. Oh, thank you. At this time, would you please stand to welcome our guests of honor, the School of the Arts class of 2021. Start walking, Will.
There you go.
Thank you. Welcome, guys. Now, if you'd please remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance and the National Anthem. To lead us in the pledge is our senior class president, Alexander Jones.
Here you go, buddy.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may be seated. Good evening. Thank you to the families, friends, SOA teachers, and faculty who are celebrating with us tonight. It is my honor to welcome you to the 2021 School of the Arts graduation ceremony. To the class of 2021, congratulations, we made it. I wish all of you the best in your future endeavors. Remember to have faith and to move forward with an open heart and mind. Our class is eager to share our creative art talents, which we have honed over the many years under the instruction of SOA's wonderful arts faculty. Enjoy the celebration and congratulations once more, class of 2021.
Good evening, students, parents, families, and friends. It is my pleasure to serve as principal of SOA and to welcome some special guests to our ceremony this evening. We have with us Dr. Helen Frazier, who's a member of the Charleston County School Board, and Robin Jones, who's the Executive Director of Instructional Programs for Charleston County. We appreciate your presence at our ceremony this evening. At SOA, our senior class isn't just a group of students. It's a community of artists, and this community has worked daily for years to refine, lift up, and celebrate the remarkable gifts and unique voices of each one of its cherished members. For this reason, it is only fitting that our seniors perform together by major one last time, shoulder to shoulder with those who have shaped, challenged, inspired them year in, year out in the classroom, in the studio, and on the stage. Our first performance features our dance majors under the direction of Kristen Tillotson and Linda Klein.
Thank you, Dr. Cook. From watching each other's dances to becoming dance partners, dance proved that it's not just an art form, but a bond that holds friendship firmly. Congratulations to the hardworking, academically and artistically talented dancers of the class of 2021. Please enjoy their original performance entitled To New Beginnings. More time for the dance majors. And now, Mr. Pickens.
The SOA Theater Department is thrilled to once again have every single senior graduate with the thesis distinction. This year, our thesis took on a whole new look, which required a whole new skill set. Our amazing students went from being stage actors to film actors, adapted all of their ideas to the screen or radio, and created some amazing work. This year, we also had several seniors participate in the virtual South Carolina Theater Association One Act Festival and bring home several awards. The theater faculty could not be more proud of each and every theater major. We wish you all the best in the years to come and break a leg.
Hi, I'm Sterling. How may I help you today, madam?
Well, I'm looking for something a little older, if you know what I mean.
Hey, Carolyn. I've been all right.
That's great to hear. I haven't seen you since your mom and I sort of fizzled.
I thought you stopped visiting.
Well, someone had to start the fizzle.
Miss Redfield, I hate to be blunt, but I have to ask. Did you kill your mother?
No, I did not in any way harm my mom.
Do you believe someone else is involved in her death?
Yes.
Probably gave her everything in your will, am I right?
I'd give her everything in the universe if I could. She's the only child who still keeps in touch with me.
Honey, I'm home!
Joe! Welcome home. What took you so long?
Papa, I gotta tell you something.
Just a second, you little rascal. What, honey?
Joe, it's after 5. Where have you been?
Well, you know me.
Jessica, if your marriage is perfectly fine, then why have you been coming to see me?
It is perfectly normal to go to marriage counseling.
Yes, it is, but you don't go to marriage counseling. You go to counseling. Your husband doesn't even know you're here.
Oh, dear, sir. Please stop. At least come inside and let me look at you.
No.
Nope.
You're forgetting...
Kids, annoying.
Julie, you're forgetting the whole motherly love aspect.
And you're forgetting the whole giving birth thing.
Okay, you do have a point.
Yeah, I know.
No, sir, I was running my brights practically the whole way up here. I'm not trying to cause any trouble, officer.
Looks like you already have, sir.
I'm sorry if I caused anything earlier. I didn't mean for there to be an argument.
Oh, no, honey, it wasn't you. Don't worry about it. You just keep your pretty little head held high, you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
I know that it's dirty, and I don't want to grapple, but I'd give just about anything for a bite of that apple.
It's not hard to believe. I'm starving like you. I'm willing to share if we'd split it in two.
Why should I share it? I'm not your serve. I saw them both first. You're on my last nerve.
Don't be that way. We're partners, you and me.
I wouldn't share this if you were on your last calorie.
And now, Miss Martin.
This is the seventh year for the costume and fashion design major at SOA, which began as an elective in a trailer in 2000. And this is our fourth class of graduating seniors. All of these ladies are CTE completers in addition to earning their SOA diplomas with thesis. Seven of these nine graduates are attending art and design schools and programs related to their field of study. Four won top awards competing against adults in the Coastal Carolina Fair. Two are Scholastic winners. One had two solo art exhibitions at Saul Alexander Gallery. One was a rising star at Piccolo Spoleto. One is salutatorian. Together, they were accepted to nine colleges and received 12 scholarships. Please enjoy their senior red carpet montage.
So we have Tomi Olaleri here. I love what you're wearing.
Thank
this is amazing.
So
I mean, you're the perfect person to wear your designs. So this is African wax print, and
yes,
then your family's from Nigeria?
Yes, I'm originally from Nigeria.
I love that you're combining your heritage and your culture and sharing it with the world.
Thank you so much.
And what do you want people to feel and think when they see your collection?
I want people to feel accomplished, and I also want people to pay attention to the colors and vibrant fabrics that I have that really represent my culture and where I come from.
We have Liz Perez Brion here, and I'm very excited to see your collection. Who do you see wearing it?
I think just any trendy, stylish teenager, maybe for prom. They're all very prom-like gowns. Just really anybody. I wish anybody.
Great. So we love formal wear. We love drama. Is this something that you would wear?
Definitely. It's my proudest collection. I love every single piece that I made this year. I'm, yes, very happy with it.
So we have Katie Gorman here. She is one of the senior fashion designers at SOA, School of the Arts. And so what are you most excited about in your collection? Do you have a favorite piece?
Yeah, so my checkered overalls that I made was definitely my favorite piece just because I put so much effort and time into it. It's definitely my favorite.
Wow. And what's on the horizon for you? What's next?
So I'm planning to attend Massachusetts College of Art and Design for my bachelor's degree in fashion design.
Very exciting. Good luck with everything, Katie. We have Simone Gathers here. Tell us a little bit about your senior thesis theme. It's very deep.
So this year I decided to do my senior thesis theme on the first ever Black-owned newspaper in the United States. It's known as the Freedom Journal, and it was started by two Black men named Samuel E. Cornish and John B. Russworm in the 1820s. I'd really like my senior thesis collection to reflect my dedication and the possible role that I can play in the fashion industry come my near future.
So we have Caroline Gladstein here, another senior fashion designer at SOA. Tell me who you see wearing your collection. Is it something that you would wear?
I would definitely wear my collection, and I'd hope that it would be accessible to the average woman.
I love that. Fashion should be accessible to everybody. Good fashion. We have Hazel Van Newkirk right now, another senior fashion designer at SOA. And what are your favorite pieces in the collection?
My favorite pieces in my collection are definitely the last two because they coincide with each other, and I think that they just embody the collection as a whole very well.
We have Mia Lassiter here. What are you most proud of in this collection as a designer?
I am most proud of my attention to detail and craftsmanship. I had been sewing for about a year before entering this major, and I wasn't aware of all of the craftsmanship and detail that went into sewing, you know, pressing the seams from the front and the back and making sure that everything lined up perfectly. So I'm most proud of how far I've come.
We have Susie Elliott here. What do you want people to think and feel when they see your work?
I really want them to be inspired by nature and really go out and interact with the natural world. This year I was really inspired by wild edible plants and birds, and you'll find my sketches throughout my collection.
I love what you're wearing. So cute. Is this kind of an inspiration for your collection?
Yes, kind of. I mean, I just got it yesterday. It's a new piece to my closet.
Okay, you love fashion. And love what are it. Your professional aspirations?
I want to become a self-made entrepreneur and a fashion designer.
And how has this major influenced you?
Well, it's made me fall more in love with fashion. Also, doing it every single day has pushed me to really pursue a career in this industry.
And now, Dr. Cook.
We're honored to have Dr. Helen Frazier, CCSD School Board Chair, here to recognize our board scholars. So I'll have her come to the stage now and recognize those students.
Good evening. On behalf of the Charleston County Schools Board of Trustees, Chairman Reverend Mack, Superintendent Dr. Posterwaite, our Principal Dr. Shannon Cook, staff, parents, and guests, for being an inspiration to all of our students during their educational careers. Students, we know it has been a challenging journey, but not one that you were not able to accomplish. Throughout their high school years, there were 103 students who excelled beyond expectations and earned an average of a 4.25 or above to become a board scholar. While the list is too long to call each by their names, we would like for you to stand and be recognized by the audience. We would like to thank you for your competitive spirit and know that you will make us proud by moving forward to greater accomplishments. Let's give them another round of applause for their accomplishments, for their tenacity, and their ability to make us proud of them. I'd also like to thank Dr. Cook again and her staff. I met Dr. Cook when I worked under her. Earlier during her career, and if just in case you did not know, she's an accomplished pianist in her own right. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Have a seat.
The SOA Creative Writing Program has been the most awarded creative writing program in the nation for well over 10 years now. And that is due in no small part to the extraordinary accomplishments of this, the 2021 class of graduating writers. These 15 seniors have won countless regional and national awards, along with a combined and unbelievable 452 Scholastic Art and Writing Awards. They've also earned acceptance into many of the world's elite colleges and universities. It might rightly be said that academic and artistic excellence have been the hallmark of this class, but so has their penchant for kindness, decency, and the good that comes of 15 artists dedicated to illuminating the world with their words and their actions.
It could have been day one.
I don't remember.
Maybe it wasn't until seventh grade.
When we dressed up like genies.
Outside of their bottles, reading palms.
And discussing everybody's futures except our own.
Maybe it was ninth grade when our class became whole.
Maybe it was 11th grade.
As we hiked up a mountain the wrong way.
I don't remember the specific moment it happened.
But somewhere between late night,
with our bare feet walking Fripp Island sands,
and early morning coffee breath,
as we read poetry to our parents, 15 strangers
turned a brick classroom into a world.
And soon, it will just be gone. No poem will be able to remind us of every moment that was spent laughing at our old short stories, or nervously waiting for our names to be called to revise a piece we had not yet written. Too soon seems to be the phrase that describes it best. Too soon, it feels. We are leaving behind the window in the classroom we used to climb through, the couches we fell asleep on, the stories we wrote that are now trapped in the walls next to our book covers.
But there will always be this year. While I can't say everything was easy, this was community and concrete, family and fallibility. Even with the long night spent with fingers cramped from typing and a yawn between every written word, even with the missing faces of those we had grown up seeing every day for 4 years, we were lucky to know that there will always be the nights we spent in the mountains singing the Phantom of the Opera. There will always be early morning Never Have I Evers on 3-hour bus rides. There will always be inside jokes about cathedrals and MJs. There will always be a place in time to look back on when we need to be reminded of the small nothings that built our childhood piece by piece.
I miss when we were young sometimes. Miss when leaving this classroom was only temporary. And I wish this poem didn't have to exist. At least not yet. I'd rather leave these memories in our mind, but this poem is just another inevitable ending that comes with getting older. Like the growing pains we felt in our calves when we were kids as we started to outgrow ourselves, it hurts the same way to accept that we're too big now to fit into this little class we call home. I remember the plot triangle our teacher drew on the whiteboard our freshman year. This class has followed the same structure as a perfect story. The exposition is our first day, awkwardly looking around at unfamiliar faces in an unfamiliar room. The rising actions occur when we begin sharing our lives outside of that room with each other, the ups and the downs. The climax is when we first realize that we won't be together forever. In the falling action, we hand each other our books, tell one another how proud we are, and then sooner than we think, we are at the resolution.
Our story finishes with us shutting the door to our world for the last time. We walk down the hallway, past our sixth grade writing that hangs from the walls, and as we read over those years-old stories and say goodbye, we are hit with the bittersweet feeling that accompanies realizing how far we've come from those little kids who didn't know each other at all.
And now, Dr. Selby.
This year, we had 14 of the seniors who took an additional recital class to earn their senior thesis in orchestra this year. We also had a record number of students who qualified to participate in the South Carolina Honors Ensembles. 67 students from our program qualified for region orchestra. 27 went on to qualify for all-state orchestra. Many of these students here played in our classroom for the entire year while we recorded what they were doing and so that the people at home could hear and play with the students that were in class. That's how we had our rehearsals for every day of the year. It was a difficult year, but I'm extremely proud of these young men and women for all that they've accomplished. Just give us a second to tune our instruments, and then we will play the Ashokan Farewell, written by Jay Unger.
Thank you.
it struck me as they were playing that this was their first live performance of the year, and at the same time, their last live performance for SOA.
At this time, we'd like to recognize our salutatorian, Mia Lassiter. While she comes forward, let me tell you a little bit about Mia. Mia is a gifted musician. She was a piano major when she originally came to SOA, and as a ninth grader, she transferred into the fashion design major. She excelled in and out of both majors while at SOA. Whether making costumes for theater, pillowcases for hospital patients, or working on her collection for the fashion show, her intelligence, drive, and wit always resulted in success. She's the founder of an organization at SOA called the Memory Project that creates portraits for international orphans and refugees. To date, her organization has delivered almost 100 handmade portraits and drawings to children around the world. Mia also works with local nonprofits to grow food and herbs for low-country food banks. Please join me in congratulating Mia Lassiter, SOA's 2021 salutatorian. And now we'd like to invite SOA's valedictorian, Michelle Schultz, to the stage. Our valedictorian is a skilled writer and a humanitarian who tirelessly works to accomplish her goals. Throughout her high school career, she has stepped forward as, okay, as a leader. Hold just a second. Are we all good? Okay, Michelle, you're coming. Come on. Throughout her high school career, she has stepped forward as a leader who identifies areas of need and encourages others to join her in making a difference. She's president of our school's award-winning Jefferson Service Club, captain of our acclaimed Quiz Bowl team, and a Girl Scouts of America ambassador. She's also the head of the National Honor Society Peer Tutoring Program. And she's managed to contribute to the community at large in all of these ways while earning the highest GPA at SOA. Please join me in congratulating SOA's valedictorian, Michelle Schultz.
You're gonna have to forgive me, this gets a little bit sappy. I first want to say thank you to everyone who supported me during these 7 years. And secondly, congratulations, class of 2021. Woo! It's so hard to believe we're finally graduating today. Many of us were here all the way back in middle school. I have all these cute little memories of growing up with Flappy Bird and Vine references and playing Five Nights at Freddy's on the scorching hot bus and sneaking Crossy Road under our desks and naming the geese on the recess field. Others joined us in high school when we ran laps together around the bus loop. We got our quarters eaten by the vending machine. We watched Notre Dame burn down in English class, and we cheered for each other at convocation. We bungeed Barbies from the roof, we made hypotonic eggs, and we solved forensic mysteries. But no matter when you came to SOA, what made our time here unique was art. And it sounds so obvious, but not everyone finds themselves in a community with the people who make art alongside them. Not everyone gets to perform Pomp and Circumstance alongside their friends, gets to perform the water dance together at Egypt Day, to have Jump, Jive, and Wail rather than Homecoming, to watch friends fill up an auditorium with the soul of a jazz number, or the soundless vibrancy of Silent Night sung from the tips of fingers. And every single person graduating today has also spent time making art in an empty room, without an audience, alone stitching darts at midnight or playing the same progression on the keys for the umpteenth time. Every single person made themselves work when they really didn't want to or they were afraid to, running frantically through an impossible ocean of lines or squeezing words onto a document when there was always something easier to do. Maybe you did things that you're proud of this year. Maybe you threw everything at the wall and it felt like nothing quite stuck. What matters is that you kept doing it. At 17 and 18 years old, many of us have made it through over a year of virtual classes, have worked a job that we hated, made it through grief and loneliness and loss. We passed our senior year bumping into noisy plexiglass dividers or watching silently through a tessellation of Zoom screens. And in this year of separation, we kept putting ourselves out there, creating and putting our work and ourselves on display, because that's what we do as artists. I keep returning to this idea of the violin players on the Titanic and how they were playing as the boat sunk down and leaned sideways, and the chairs were skidding down the deck, and they kept playing in spite of the tragedy that was unfolding around them, and their music was made that much more meaningful because of it. It's a bit dramatic and corny, of course, but I think it's so powerful that as this catastrophe of historical proportions was happening around us, we kept moving our bows across those strings. As humans, we make art in spite of and because of the struggles we face. We have the choice to take what's thrown at us and make it useful to ourselves, whether it's isolation or boredom or heartbreak or loss. And so often we did. We wrote books and painted beautiful studies of the human condition. We performed our theses in an empty sound booth and deprived ourselves of sleep so that we could keep making art and make it mean something. But the Titanic metaphor isn't perfect either, because whether we were 6 feet apart or separated by miles, today, by some miracle, we're reunited, together in the same stadium, celebrating with our classmates and family and friends. And although there were people who couldn't make it today, and although the journey wasn't quite what we expected, now we can properly bid farewell to this previous chapter and all the twists and new beginnings that came along with it. The painful and wonderful parts of those seven or however many years have passed into another land. Their essence is folded away into the diploma that will rest in your hands very soon. Those times have come to a close. Flappy Bird has been taken down from the App Store. The vines now rest in YouTube compilations. But as long as the vending machine stays broken and the geese roam the parking lot, we'll know that we have a home here with these passionate, kind, brilliantly talented people who understand what it means to leave a piece of themselves everywhere that they touch. Thank you for these years, class of 2021. I can't wait to see what we create next.
Good evening. I'm Ken Turner, Director of Bands here at SOA. The SOA High School Band Program enjoys a national reputation for excellence. We are one of the few band programs in the state that feature two fully instrumented symphonic bands and two fully instrumented jazz bands. Very few jazz band programs in our state could pull off an event such as our Jump, Jive, and Wail, that where our jazz band presents a three-hour-long concert with over 25 songs in October. Of the 92 total band members in the SOA High School Band this year, 52 members earned a chair in the SCBDA All-State Band, All-State Jazz Band, or SCBDA Region Bands. Many of our band seniors will continue their musical journey in college, and several are majoring in music performance. Please welcome the SOA band majors for their last performance as they play Shenandoah by Tekeli.
Good evening. I'm Barbara Richardson, senior visual art teacher. Visual art seniors, meeting online and in person, were tasked with creating meaningful, original works of art that demonstrated skill, artistic growth, and personal vision, while juggling non-traditional school schedules, disruptions in daily life, a new set of fears, and a new level of anxiety, the absence of socialization and peer support. This group of visual artists represents one of the most accomplished students of this department have ever seen, earning one award after another, along with public art commissions, large scholarships, and invitations to enroll in their top choice schools. We say goodbye and thank you to an incredible group of artists as they take their next big step and embark on futures that will no doubt reinforce the legacy of SOA, leaving their marks in the world. Please enjoy this video prepared by our senior artist. Thank you, and up next is Ms. Benson.
Good evening. The SOA Piano Department has continued its excellence in performance this extraordinary year. We have had many students that participated in Achievement Day competition, district and state auditions, earning outstanding ratings. We had students that were selected to honors recitals for all of these organizations. We had a winner of the SCMTA Concerto Competition, a winner in the PTSA Reflections Competition for Composition, two winners in the Sonatina Competition and the MTNA Competition. We produced numerous virtual concert series for both our classical and jazz programs. This year, we're proud to have two seniors, Lucy Richmond and J.T. Holmuller, who will continue studying music as their major at the College of Charleston and Berkeley in Boston. Congratulations to the 2021 piano seniors. We wish you the best in your future endeavors, and please enjoy their performance of Moving Out. And now, Ms. Caffarel.
The senior vocal majors have become a versatile and distinguished group of singers during their study at SOA. They have performed in great music halls like Carnegie Hall and with groups such as the Mormon Tabernacle Choir. They have been the highest-ranked singers for the South Carolina High School All-State Choir, and have frequently had the largest representation from any school. Many of them were selected to perform with the ACDA National Choirs in Salt Lake City, Minneapolis, and Kansas City. The SOA singers have shared the stage with the Charleston Symphony Orchestra, North Charleston Pops Orchestra, and SOA's own Symphony Orchestra. Many of these singers will continue their vocal training in college and university choirs. Tonight, the singers will take the stage for their last performance, singing Graduation Medley by Anthem Lights.
I hope the days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go.
And if you're faced with a choice, then you have to choose. I hope you choose the one that means the most to you.
Hope you still feel small when you stand beside the ocean.
Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens.
Promise me that you'll give faith the fighting chance.
And if it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything,
I hope you dance. I hope you
dream I'm dreaming. There's a voice inside my head saying you'll never reach it. But I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep my head held high.
My wish for you in that this life becomes
all that you wanted.
When you take that jump, you don't feel the fall.
Hope when the water rises, you've built a wall.
My wish.
What's up, class of 2021? My name is Lily Sue Staita, SOA student body president. At SOA, our purpose is to provide a supportive educational environment where academic and artistic challenges engage students and lead them to develop and use their talents to pursue goals and contribute to society. The graduates of School of the Arts have had the opportunity to earn an SOA credential over the course of their 4 years in high school. The SOA credential fosters the development of shared partnerships with artistic professionals, a culture of service learning and community involvement, an understanding of all art disciplines through rigorous humanities courses, and high student achievement in both art and academic classes.
Hello, good evening. My name is Laura Smith, and I am an administrator here at School of the Arts. Thank you. Dr. Cook, I would like to present these students as candidates for graduation. Litzy Margarita Flores Guandique. Tamor D. Montgomery. Yay! Audrey Annalise Tevis. Thank you. Next, please welcome Mr. Turner.
Dr. Cook, it is my pleasure to present these band majors as candidates for graduation. Andrew James Bednarczyk, with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Jonathan Davis Black, with thesis. Tiffany Chan. Sarah Elizabeth Coggins, with thesis. Kyla Janae Conyers, with thesis and SOA credential. Andrew Pierce Crosby, with thesis. Maria Pilar Del Mastro. John Samuel Feingold, with thesis. Allison Taylor Green. Michael Mosley Hart. Woo! Walsh Hart. Alexander Michael Jones with thesis. Cameron Xavier Jones. Hannah Marie Jones with thesis. Christina Marie Kerr. Samuel Jonas Kremser with thesis. Vigi Sonora LeBlanc with thesis. Charles Pasquale McGuinn. Isabel Zlatanova Raykova with thesis and SOA credential. Franklin Emmanuel Summers with thesis. Kelsey Blaze Thorvaldson. Victoria Francis Ward. Band majors, you may now be seated. And now, Mr. Hammes with creative writing.
Would the creative writing majors please stand and come up here? Dr. Cook, it is my honor to present our creative writing majors as candidates for graduation. Logan Elizabeth Baker with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Caroline Elizabeth Bloomer with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Autumn Isabella Chiveco with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Clara Isabel Collins with thesis and SOA credential. Hannah Reese Elledge with thesis. Catherine Marie Forrester with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Brianna Kiera Green with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Did I get it? Charles Edmund Hastings with thesis and SOA credential. Benjamin Edward Hudd with thesis. Bojena Lavinia Sabin with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Our valedictorian, Michelle Kristen Schultz, with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Julianne Reed Smith, with thesis. Anna Katharina Temples, with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Huh? Ramey Elizabeth Thompson with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Sincere Amarice Washington with thesis. Thank you, creative writing majors. You may now be seated. And now, Ms. Tillotson with dance.
Dr. Cook, it is my honor to present these dance majors as candidates for graduation. Haley Elizabeth Curtis with thesis. Yeah. Caitlin Ann Everman with thesis and SOA credential. Caitlin Abigail Hall with thesis and SOA credential. Jaylee Beth Hittner with thesis and SOA credential. Anya Ariane Hutchins with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Kaylee Turner Lightsley with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Catherine Leanne Nutter with thesis. Catherine Elizabeth Oswald with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Ashlyn Grace Pyle with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Aiden Grace Reimer with thesis and SOA credential. Piper Glenn Enright Reinwald with thesis. Madeline Olson Stisher with thesis and SOA credential. Justice Jalen Wooden with thesis and SOA credential.
Thank you, dance majors. You may be seated. And now Ms. Martin with costume and fashion design.
Will the fashion and costume design majors come up to on the stage? Dr. Cook, I would like to present the fashion and costume design majors as candidates for graduation. Susan Claire Elliott with thesis in fashion and visual arts and SOA credential. Simone Shanae Gaithers with thesis. Caroline Wilson Gladstein with thesis. Yay. Katie Lynn Gorman with thesis. Kelsey Claire Hansen with thesis. And our salutatorian, Mia Adele Lassiter with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Oluwa Thomason, Anju Aloa, Olalere with thesis and SOA credential. Lizbeth Perez Brion with thesis. Yay, you're welcome. Hazel Francis Vanukirk with thesis. Thank you, fashion and costume design majors. You may now be seated. Next, Ms. Benson and piano.
Dr. Cook, it is my pleasure to present these piano majors as candidates for graduation. Ryan Hugh Faust with thesis. Samuel Albert Hagen with thesis. Joseph Tien Homoller with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Joseph Imbo. Lucy Dupree Richmond with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Kylie Michelle Stevens with thesis and SOA credential. Nicholas Walter Tumler with thesis. Thank you, piano majors. You may now be seated. And now Dr. Selby and strings.
String majors, please stand. Dr. Cook, it is my honor to present the following string majors as candidates for graduation. Isabella Rose Andrews with thesis and SOA credential. J. James Ethan Butler. Margaret Elizabeth Carter, with thesis and SOA credential. Isabella Charity Colley, with thesis and SOA credential. Jackson Cyril Coatsworth. Marcos Ramon Colon. Ava Marie Diamond, with thesis. Abigail Mackenzie George. Emma San Kathy Hales. Patrick Stephen Hamilton. Emma Rose Joyce, with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Caitlin Alexis Kogler, with thesis. Markayla Elise Miller. Anya Sean Newby, with thesis and SOA credential. Chi Tian Nguyen. Jeffrey Marshall MacArthur, with thesis. Sophie Ann Stalnicker, with thesis. Lillian Elizabeth Sestida, with thesis. Lily Mae Thames, with thesis. Lily Haynes Tipton, with thesis. Emma Margaret Weeks, with thesis and SOA credential. And Tristan Oliver Wells, with thesis. Thank you, string majors. You may be seated. And now, Mr. Pickens, with theater.
Dr. Cook, I would like to present the theater majors as candidates for graduation. Elijah Valentine Aiken Dietz, with thesis. Naja Sabira Aleem with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Hannah Diane Bendure with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Mia Rachel Bowersox with thesis. Brianna Lillian Breckenridge with thesis. Victoria Jesse Copeland with thesis. Abby Jasmine Gardner with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Leah Rochelle McLeod Hand with thesis. Elizabeth McLeod Herring with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Tyler Anthony Herman with thesis. Luke Dean Linhart with thesis. Riley Elizabeth Main with thesis and SOA credential. Solera Michaela Morrison with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Dixon Dean Moss with thesis. Aaron Hunter Poole with thesis. Caden Molnar Spitz with thesis. Davis Bratton Varnado with thesis. Colin Scott Ware with thesis. Aiden Rose Wonderly with thesis. And Nikki Zahedi with thesis. Thank you, theater majors. You may now be seated. And now, Ms. Richardson with visual arts.
Would the visual artists majors please stand? Dr. Cook, I would like to present these visual arts majors as candidates for graduation. Esme Louise Barna with thesis. Enrique Jamal Boyd with thesis. Brooke Legree Brunson with thesis. Faith Marie Jurinski with thesis. Ellis Davy Fox with thesis and SOA credential. McKenna Elaine Fugate with thesis. Maya Elizabeth Genegrasso with thesis. Sophie Ann Heidold with thesis and SOA credential. Olivia Schuhau with Jones with thesis. Julian Rice Kuklik with thesis. Shivani Prabha Pandey with thesis. Esther Magdarella Ray with thesis. Julia Jean Shepherd Shook with thesis. William Zane Salmons with thesis. Luna Steedley with thesis. Kenna Lee Steele with thesis. Ella Rain Waldron Noring with thesis. Andrew Layton Webb with thesis. Visual artist, you may now be seated. Now please welcome Ms. Caffarel with vocal.
Dr. Cook, I am honored to present these vocal majors as candidates for graduation. Lily Adier Johnson. Lauren Jeanette Bailey. William Miller Brown. Margot Dayton Coley with thesis and SOA credential. Travis Matthew Daneker. Grace Meredith Estes. Laura Delaney Fail with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. James Elijah Jennings. Alyssa Nicole Johnson.
Congratulations.
Tay Scott Jones. John Wesley Cornarens with thesis. The third. Savannah Lee Lanyo. Caitlin Kelly Martin. Estrella Angelina Mercado. Logan Abel Murray with thesis and SOA credential with distinction. Yes. Eurasia Ahinsa Randall. Hey. Harper Elizabeth Reed. George Ethan Temple. AKA Gates. Zen Lorenzo Vinson. Hannah Michelle Washington. Jonathan Anthony Yunmen E with thesis and SOA credential. And last but not least, we would like to recognize Aubrey Oates. We are proud to say that she has not only completed her graduation requirements, but she has beaten leukemia and is doing well after undergoing a bone marrow transplant just a few weeks ago. Aubrey Elizabeth Oates with thesis and SOA credential.
Seniors, will you please stand? One thing I wanted to say is tucked inside your diploma covers is a note that was written to you by the teacher you said was most influential over the course of your 12 years in education. Don't read it now, but it's written just for you. We wanted you to have something as you exited. So, with the power vested in me by the state of South Carolina and the Charleston County School Board, I verify that the candidates have satisfied the requirements for the South Carolina High School Diploma. At this time, I hereby certify these diplomas of the graduating class of Charleston County School of the Arts for 2021. You may move your tassels, and then our vocal majors will lead us in SOA's alma mater. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. Congratulations, class of 2021.